Hello viewers, welcome to Salt and Pepper. Today I'll show you how to cook Hyderabad style chicken dum biryani in a pressure cooker. Let's start the recipe. For this, we need to marinate the chicken a night before cooking the biryani. For this, we need 600 to 700 grams of chicken, which I have washed. If you have any large pieces or leg pieces, slit them nicely such that masalas get absorbed. Take a clean bowl, add 3/4 cup of curd, 1.5 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, to which I have added some mint leaves and 4 chilies and grinded it to a fine paste. Don't skip the mint, it adds nice flavor to the chicken. 1.5 teaspoon of salt, a pinch of turmeric, 1 teaspoon of chili powder. This masala makes a medium spicy biryani. If you want to reduce the spice, adjust the chili powder accordingly. 1/4 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder, 1 teaspoon of garam masala. This is homemade and it has all the biryani spices, so I don't need any biryani masala. If you don't have like this, replace it with some store-bought biryani masala. And 1 full lemon. Mix the masalas well and check the salt. Add if it is required. To this, I'm adding 1 to 2 spoons of oil. By adding oil, it gives nice texture to the chicken once it is cooked. Add chicken to the masalas and rub it nicely so that masala is evenly coated to each and every chicken piece. Now I will store this in the refrigerator for the whole night and next day I'll prepare the biryani. Next day, take a pan, add 1/2 teaspoon of ghee and few throw some cashews. If you don't want cashews in your biryani, you can completely skip this step. This is optional. Take out the cashews and add 2 to 3 teaspoons of oil to the same pan and fry the onions that are sliced. I have taken 1 big size onion. These are for the fried onions in your biryani. If you want to use some store-bought onions, you can completely skip this step. But homemade fried onions gives nice flavor. While the onions are getting fried, I have taken a vessel with 8 cups of water. I have already soaked 3 cups of basmati rice. For that, I have taken 8 cups of water. To this, I am adding 1 teaspoon of oil, 2 to 3 teaspoons of salt, 1 whole spices, bay leaf, cinnamon, cardamom, cloves, shajira, star. I'm adding this to water and let the water to come to boil. This is about 4 to 5 minutes. Onions are nice and crisp. Let's keep it aside. Now the water has come to boil. Add the soaked rice to it and let it cook till 80%. It will take about 4 to 5 minutes. Meanwhile, let's prepare the cooker for dum. In the cooker, I have added 1.5 teaspoon of oil and spread it nicely such that nothing sticks to the cooker while dum. Now, layer the marinated chicken in the bottom of cooker. Don't stack the chicken pieces. If you stack the chicken pieces, it won't cook properly. Add all the remaining masalas and spread it nicely. Now I am adding 1/2 onion which is roughly chopped. By adding onion, it will ensure that masalas are evenly spread to the rice as well once it is cooked. Now the rice is 80% cooked. Let's turn off the flame and drain the water and add the rice to the cooker. Before adding the rice, I am layering the chicken with chopped coriander, fried cashews and fried onions. Then I will layer this with 80% cooked rice. You can drain the rice all together, or you can drain it as shown in the video. On top of this, we'll add 1/2 teaspoon of ghee. If you have saffron, add it to hot milk and add the saffron milk. Otherwise, you can sprinkle some water on top so that the top layer of rice won't get dried up. Now let's close the lid with the gasket and put on the weight as well. This has to cook on high flame for 7 minutes, medium flame for 7 minutes and then 15 minutes on a low flame. Now it's been 10 minutes that I have turned off the flame. The cooker is cool now. Let's open and see how the biryani is cooked. As I have taken a small cooker, I don't have enough room to insert a spoon, so I'm taking it to a separate vessel. Look, nothing has stuck to the cooker bottom. It looks so delicious and mouth-watering. If you like this recipe, please do like, share and comment on this video, and do subscribe to Salt and Pepper. Thanks for watching the video.